Hi guys, my name is Alex. In this quick tip tutorial I'm going to try to explain to you how you can use slice curve brush in ZBrush 4R6 so it works as it did in the earlier versions. So here I have a polymeshed 3D sphere which I'm going to under geometry dynamesh it, blur 0, project off, groups on, and dynamesh it. Now I'm going to hold Control Shift and select slice curve, and I'm just going to hold Control Shift and slice it through this object. Pressing Shift F on the keyboard, you can see the polyframes and it just created two polygroups. And now if you hold Control and click and drag on the canvas, it looks like it separated these two polygroups, but this is not the case. In the earlier version this was everything you needed to do to get two separate parts, but now in 4R6 this is a little bit different, because now if you go for example into transpose tools and hold Control and click on this upper one and then try to move it, you can see it's still attached to something in this object. So what it created two additional polygroups for the flat faces of this object, which is used for I don't know what. It's just a pain in the ass, because you have to do an additional step going down the polygroups and set this maximal angle tolerance to 90 and group by normals. Now if you go back to transpose tools, pressing W on the keyboard, holding Control and click and click on this upper part, and if you move it now you can see you get two different parts which you can split, and they have these nice edges, flat faces attached to them. Because if we go back a couple of steps, if we wouldn't group normals by 90 degrees, and if we would hold Control Shift and click on it, we would see that we have a flat face, we have a hole in it, which is not what we are looking for. So this can be fixed by going to polygroups and making sure you have maximum angle tolerance set 90 and group by normals. Another thing I would like to show you, how you can create an additional step in the slice. So holding Control Shift then click and double tap Alt and then just go down, and now Control Shift click and drag on the canvas, and going to polygroups and group by normals, you would expect it to make this nice transition, but it doesn't. As you can see here, it just closed the hole, but it didn't take into account that you want a sharp edge here. So how you can fix this? You have to make another additional step. So Control Shift and slice through, sorry for that. So I just sliced it through and holding Control and click and drag on the canvas to poly to redynamesh it, and then just click on group by normals, and then again holding Control Shift you must slice it again, and again Control click and drag on the canvas and group by normals. If you now click on Control Shift and click on this bottom part, you can see you have this nice transition of edges, but we want the other part grouped as well without these edges applied. So we are going to press Control W to make everything into one polygroup, and holding Control Shift and click on the canvas to make everything visible again, holding Control click and drag on the canvas to redynamesh it, and if you have some residue of this earlier polygroups, you just smooth it out. So now if you control shift and click on it, you can see you have this hole closed and it respects this edge. So this is it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something new. Check out the rest of the videos, subscribe to my channel, share it, and till next time, bye.